This is Elizabeth Garrett Anderson. You may not know her, but she was Britain's first ever female doctor. Born in 1836 in Whitechapel, Elizabeth was the second of 12 children. At 18, she met Emily Davis, a feminist and suffragist. Davis campaigned heavily for women's right to university education and was a key figure in Elizabeth's life as a person who inspired and encouraged her to strive for success without letting her gender limit her. In 1863, she met Elizabeth Blackwell, the first American female physician. She had a profound impact on Anderson, lighting a strong ambition in her to become a doctor despite all the barriers she faced ahead. She tried to apply to medicine at the Middlesex Hospital without success, but this didn't stop her. She chose to enroll as a nursing student and attended classes intended for male doctors, but was then barred after complaints from the male students. This only drove Elizabeth's ambition further, and after finding a loophole in the charter of the Society of Apothecaries, she set out to join. However, her desire to become a doctor never wavered. Still unable to gain her medical degree in this country, she taught herself French and went to the University of Paris, where the dean was more open to the idea of female medical students. In 1870, she obtained France's first ever medical degree for a woman, but the British Medical Register refused to recognise her qualification. In 1872, Elizabeth founded the new Hospital for Women in London, staffed entirely by women. Anderson appointed her mentor and friend Elizabeth Blackwell as a professor of gynaecology there. But her greatest achievement was in 1876, when as a culmination of hers and other women's efforts, an act was passed permitting women to enter the medical profession. Elizabeth's determination paved the way for other women by enduring and overcoming incredible prejudice and hostility towards her strong ambitions. Elizabeth Garrett Anderson died in 1917, but her legacy lives on in every woman after her, whose dreams, ambitions, and quest for knowledge need not just be fantasy, but reality.